Hello dear students and welcome back in our biology session. So today we will move for the next organ system, that is nothing but what? Respiratory system. Okay. So as we know, in our previous video we have discussed that there are so many different systems are there which are works in our body. Among that already we have discussed about the digestive system. So now today we will discuss the next system in our body that is very important also, that is what? Respiratory system. Okay. So what is the work of the respiratory system? The main work the respiratory systems can perform the very important process, that is nothing but what? Respiration. Okay. So the work of the respiratory system is what? To perform respiration. And why it is necessary to perform the respiration? Yes, it is very important to perform the respiration because whatever the food we are having, okay, or the whatever the food we are having, from that food we are getting energy, like that we are telling, okay. But from how the energy we are getting from the food? With the help of this respiration process. Okay. So the food we are having, that food get digested, and that digested food can get breakdown and then release the energy, and that process is only called as what? Respiration, which is performed by the respiratory system. Okay. So why we have to do the respiration? To get the enough amount of energy to our body, or to do the different activities, and for that different activities we require the energy, and that energy we are getting from this respiration. Okay. So let's see what is mean by respiration. Respiration is the process of taking in oxygen, using it for the release of energy by breakdown of food and removing the waste products, carbon dioxide and water. Okay. So what is mean by the respiration? Respiration is the process in which what happens? In that process, in the respiration process, we are inhale the air which is rich in oxygen, and that oxygen is get utilized to break down the food and to release the energy, and also it is helpful to release some waste products like carbon dioxide and water. Okay. So this is about what? Respiration. It means what? Taking in oxygen, that oxygen used to break down the food. From the breakdown of the food, oxygen is get released. With the help of that also, some excretory products are also get removed, and the excretory products like what? Carbon dioxide and water. Okay. So this respiration step or the respiration process involves the two basic steps. Okay. Which are the two basic steps? We will discuss now. It involves the two steps, that are external respiration. For that only we are calling as what? Breathing. And next one is what? Internal respiration, which is also called as what? Cellular respiration. Okay. So the respiration involves the two steps, that are external respiration and internal respiration. Let's see what is mean by external respiration. External respiration is also called as what? Breathing. Okay. So what is mean by external respiration and the breathing? So the inhale of the oxygen rich air and exhale of the carbon dioxide air, the air which is rich in carbon dioxide, with the help of the different respiratory organs, and that process is called as what? External respiration or breathing. Or also we can say that what? Inhale of the oxygen rich air and exhaling of the carbon dioxide rich air, that process is called as what? Breathing or external respiration. Okay. In the respiration, one more step is involved, that is what? Internal respiration, or it is also called as what? Cellular respiration. Let's see what is mean by internal respiration or the cellular respiration. The process of breakdown of food in the cells with release of energy is called internal respiration. Okay. So the process of breakdown of the food in the cell, okay, with release of energy. So the process of the breakdown of the food is happens in the cell. Okay, so as we know, all the living organisms are made up of the cell, and cell is what? Structural and the functional unit of an living organism. Okay, so the breakdown of the food is happens into the cell of an living organism. Why? To release the energy, and that process is called as what? Internal respiration or cellular respiration. Okay, so this is about what? Internal respiration. So these are the two basic steps which are involved in the respiration, that are external respiration and the internal respiration. And that is the reason we are telling that, or in our previous class we have discussed that respiration or the breathing are the two different processes. Okay, breathing is different and the respiration is different, but these both the processes are correlated to each other. Okay, because without breathing the cellular respiration is not possible. Okay, so these are the two steps involved in the respiration. Okay, now we'll move for the next point, that is on the basis of whether the oxygen is get used in the cellular respiration, the cellular respiration is having the two types. Okay, on the basis of whether oxygen is used up or not, cellular respiration is having two types. Okay, let's discuss that. So the two types of the cellular respiration are, first one is aerobic respiration. Okay, first type of the cellular respiration is what? Aerobic respiration. Okay, let's see what is mean by aerobic respiration. The breakdown of food into carbon dioxide and water. Okay, so the breakdown of the food into which substances? The breakdown of the food into carbon dioxide and water to release the energy in the presence of oxygen, which is very important one, student, keeps in the mind. What? The breakdown of food into carbon dioxide and water to release energy in the presence of oxygen is called which respiration? Aerobic respiration. Okay, it is called as what? Aerobic respiration. Aerobic respiration. Okay, so the breakdown of food into carbon dioxide and water to release energy in the presence of oxygen, and that respiration is called as what? Aerobic respiration. So that aerobic respiration we can write in the equation also. See, glucose. Glucose means what? Whatever the food we are having which is rich in a glucose. Okay, that is complex carbohydrate which get converts into the simple sugar, that is nothing but what? Glucose. Okay, so the glucose means what? The food we are having also with the help of the oxygen, means we, what we can write here, with oxygen, what it get convert? It can get convert into carbon dioxide, water, and also they release the energy. Okay, so this is about what? Aerobic respiration. Okay, now we'll move for the next type of the cellular respiration, that is anaerobic respiration. Okay, that is what? Anaerobic respiration. Okay, let's see what is mean by the anaerobic respiration. So the breakdown of the food happens into, the breakdown of food into alcohol and carbon dioxide. Okay, so in the anaerobic respiration the breakdown of the food is happen, but that food is get converted, the breakdown of the food it produce two products, that are what? Alcohol and carbon dioxide, with the release of energy in the absence of oxygen. Okay, in the absence of oxygen, and it is called anaerobic respiration. Okay, so the breakdown of the food into, the food get converted into alcohol and carbon dioxide, also they release the energy, but this process is done in the absence of oxygen, and that type of the respiration is called as what? Anaerobic respiration. That also we can write in the equation. For example, we can say that glucose, which is very important, next one on the arrow I have written, without O2, means for without oxygen, they release alcohol, carbon dioxide, and also they release the energy. Okay, so this is about what? Anaerobic respiration. So what you have to keep in the mind, Aerobic means what? In the presence of oxygen, they release carbon dioxide, water and energy. Anaerobic respiration, in the absence of oxygen, they release alcohol, carbon dioxide and energy. Okay, so this is the two types of the cellular respiration on the basis of whether the oxygen is get used up or no. Okay, now we'll move for the next point, that is what? Anaerobes. Okay, there are so rare organisms those who are showing the anaerobic respiration. Okay, and the organism those who are showing the anaerobic respiration, it means what? The organism those who can perform the respiration process in the absence of oxygen, that organisms are called as what? Anaerobes. Okay, anaerobes means what? The organism those who are performing the respiration without oxygen, that organisms are called as what? Anaerobes. And the examples for the same are what? Yeast and certain types of the bacteria can perform the anaerobic respiration. Okay, now next one we will talk about the breathing rate. Okay, so the breathing is the process which are going on continuously or throughout our life. Okay, so what is mean by the breathing rate? The how many times the person is doing breathing, it is called as what? In a 1 minute, or the how many times the person is performing the breathing in a 1 minute, that rate is called as what? Breathing rate. Okay, so in a 1 minute, how many times we are doing breathing, it is only called as what? Breathing rate. Okay, so the normally the average breathing rate of an adult or the human being is what? 15 to 18 times a minute. Means within a minute, the human being, the healthy adult person, can do the breathing 15 to 18 times. Okay, but this is in the raised position. Okay, so see, whenever we are having so much heavy exercise or we are having some physical activity, we are jumping, running, then that time what happened? We are doing breathing process very fast. Why? Because that time our body requires the more amount of the energy, and to get that more amount of the energy, our body requires oxygen also. So we are doing the breathing very fast, and that time the breathing rate is get increased. Okay, so in this way, the breathing rate, the adult, the average breathing rate is what? 15 to 18 times. But if we are having exercise, we are having physical activity, then it get increases. Okay, and to fulfill the energy or the need of that energy, our body taking the more amount of the oxygen, that's why we are taking the very long breath to take the more and more amount of the oxygen, and that oxygen is get utilized to break down the food and to release the energy. Okay, so this is all about what? Breathing rate. Okay, so today we have discussed about the respiration, which two processes involved in that, that are what? External respiration, internal respiration. Two types of the cellular respiration, that are aerobic, anaerobic. Also we have discussed about the anaerobes and the breathing rate. Here we will stop. We will meet in the next video with the next point. It's time to tell you goodbye, and for today, thank you.